He say, but now if the good people they migrate, if the good people they leave, those who are the people of Salah, those are people of rectification, if they leave the Muslim land because of the facade and they fear for themselves, he say that what who will be remaining in the land for those who are yani in the land of evil, the land of facade, the land of corruption, who will be in there? He say من الذي يبقى لأهل الفساد, who will be there for the people of corruption, who will be there to rectify the issues, to يعني الأمر بالمعروف and والنهي عن المنكر, who will be there to enjoy the good and forbid the evil. So he mentioned in here, he say وربما ينحر البلاد أكثر بسبب قلة أهل الصلاح وكثرة أهل الفساد والفسوق. He mentioned, but even if the people that have يعني alhamdulillah righteousness or they have knowledge and the like, and they يعني move away from the land of corruption, then who will remain in that land? And he say even perhaps وربما ينحر, he say but perhaps sometime that the land will be even seeking deeper, يعني sinking in that which is يعني being more evil, being more corrupted and being more upon evil and upon sins. طيب, he say لكن, but we say إذا بقى ودعا إلى الله بحسب حاله فسوف يصلح غيره. He say but if the individual he remain and he call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning to call the people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to the best of his ability and to the best of the situation, he say perhaps that the outcome will be rectification, meaning for himself and for others. And he mentioned, he say يصلح غيره حتى يكون هؤلاء على أيديهم الصلاح البلاد. He say that he will remain and call يعني the people to what is right until that the people that are there of the righteousness, they will be the one to be in charge of the country. And therefore it is to be known that when the people that are in charge of the country, they are righteous, then walhamdulillah, then there is a high hope that the country will remain upon righteousness. He say وَإِذَا صَلُحَ عَامَّةِ النَّاسِ, if the general people they are correct, they are upon correctness, he say فَإِنَّ الْغَالِبِ أن من بيده الحكم يصلح. He say that if the people in general they are correct, then out yani 9 out of 10, those who will be in charge of the country, they will be from people that are the good people. They will be from the people that are of righteousness, of correctness, and of rectification. He say ولو على طريق التدريب. He say even if it is by way of pressure. طيب, even if it is by way of pressure, meaning يعني the majority of people they are righteous. طيب, the one that is the leader, even he feel pressure to be righteous because of the people are righteous. طيب, مثلا the people alhamdulillah they are upon istiqama, the people living in the country they are upon istiqama. مثلا they, you know, you see them, the men having their beard and you know and the like, يعني following the sunnah. Now even the individual he is not about that or he's not upon that, he will feel to do it because of pressure. Because you see everybody doing the same thing, so he was feel like pressure to do the same thing. So Shaykh Uthaymeen rahimahullah wa rahmatan wasi'ah, he went to say, he say لكن الذي يفسد هذا, but he say those who are those from the people that corrupt this, he say al-asaf, unfortunately, he say sometime it is the salihuna anfusahum, those who are upon correctness themselves. Those who corrupt you sometime, they are those who sometime they are upon what is correct. He say, فَتَجِدُ هَؤُلَى الصَّالِحِينَ. طيب, he talking about the Muslim country. He said that you'll find some of the people that are alhamdulillah righteous, they will be having any dispute and they will be having any argumentation, وَتَخْتَلِفْ كَلِمَتَهُمْ, and they will have any disagreement. He say from يعني in regard to the speech and the like, من أجل الخلاف في مسألة من مسائل الإسلام الدين التي يغتفر فيها الخلاف. So meaning those who are يعني in correctness or those who have knowledge and the like, sometimes they will be the one that are be corrupting the country. He said, why? Because they'll be having some dispute. They'll be having some argumentation. And they'll be having some disagreement in regard to their opinion of matters of the religion. And you say, even these matters of the religion, you say, يغتفر فيها الخلاف. They are matters that it is open to be having disagreement in it. It is matters that is open to have different of opinion in those issues. And he mentioned هذا هو الواقع. And he say this is really what is happening. He say لا سيما في بلاد التي لم يثبت فيها الإسلام تماما. And more so in those religion where Islam is not strongly rooted. Where Islam is not strongly rooted. But here when we say strongly rooted, meaning where the knowledge, the pure knowledge is not strongly rooted in there. It's not that Islam is not rooted, meaning strongly rooted, meaning the people, they are jadid fil Islam, they are new to Islam. But rather, la, they could be Muslim for a long time, but the pure knowledge is not rooted. It's not something that is well cemented in them. He mentioned that la siyama, and also in those countries that Islam is not well rooted, it is not well established in it, tamam and completely established. He said, rubama, sometime, yata'adawna, and they will have enmity. ويتباغضون, and they will have they will be angry at one another, they will be having enmity at one another, and they will be distancing one another من أجل مسألة. He say in regard to some of the issues, and he give the example of the رفع اليدين في الصلاة. طيب رفع اليدين في الصلاة, and they will be having a dispute or argumentation based on issues like raising the hands in the صلاة. Like this, raising the hands in the salah. Tayyip, having your hands on your chest in the salah. And subhanAllah, one of the brothers, he mentioned that in their town or whatever the case might be, you go to some of the masajid and you pray like this, he say, literally the people will take a stick and hit you with it. And this is an issue that is what? An issue that is open for barakallahu feekum. This issue is open to have khilaf, because there is nothing that they can hold on to say that, well, if you pray, you can have your hands down. There is no da'if hadith that even say this. Tayyip. But the person praying with his hands down, this is nothing to say that his prayer is invalid. Tayyip. Ain't nobody will say that his prayer is invalid. And he mentioned, let's say, these issues. And the Shahar fi Dhuha, he say, وَأَقْرَوَ عَلَيْكُمْ قِسَّةٌ وَقَعَدْ لِي شَخْصًا أَوْ شَخْصًا فِي مِنَّ. He say, I will say to you, he say, وَأَقْرَوَ عَلَيْكُمْ, that I will read to you. But he's not reading it, but he, أَقْرَوَ عَلَيْكُمْ, it means I will tell you, or I will recite to you, mean I will tell you. He say, وَأَقْرَوَ عَلَيْكُمْ, and I will say to you, a qissa, something that happened, that I witnessed myself. طيب. Then he say, two people in Minna, he say, في يوم من الأيام, in one of those days, that they were arguing and they were having issues. So he mentions, one of them say, السنة في القيام أن تدع للمصلي يدعو على صدره. The one of them said that from the sunnah is that the person, he put his hands on the chest. طيب. والآخر يقول, the other one say, السنه ان يطلق اليدين. And the other one say, well, the sunnah is that you drop both of your hands down, just like some of the people pray. طيب. وهذه المسألة, and Shaykh Uthaymeen رحمه الله تعالى, he said that this issue is what is called mas'ala furu'iyya. It is from those branches. It is not from the principle of the religion. It is from the branches of the religion. He says sahlatun, and it is an easy matter. He says laysa min al-usuli wal-furu'. It is not even from the secondary matters of the religion. It is not from the primary matters, meaning the usul, nor from the branches of the religion. So it is something that is barakallahu feekum, neither from the usul of the religion, nor it is from the furu of the religion. Qalu, one say, la, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, an nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yaqul man raghiba an sunnati falaysa minni, aw falaysa minna, falaysa minni. And the other one say, well, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, whoever Whoever يعني turn away from my sunnah, he is not from us. وهذا كفر أو هذا كفر يعني, and he said that this individual, he make takfir of the other one بتركي, by way of him abandoning something that he said the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم has done. طيب, and سبحان الله العظيم that this what Shaykh Ibn رحمه الله تعالى mentioned that he has seen it. And this is also when some of the people they alhamdulillah first and then start embarking upon learning the sunnah or practicing the sunnah without not being deep in, not I'm not saying deep in knowledge, but not being alhamdulillah learnt طيب, to know certain things, they will see these issues as being this way or the other way. طيب, even somebody called, so call somebody that is dragging his pants to be a kafir. Or call somebody just because he's wearing amulets, well, you are a mushrik. No, it's not so. A person can be wearing amulets and not be a mushrik. Because if he believe that Allah will help him with that amulets, he's not a mushrik. But if he believe that the amulets are the one that aiding him, then this is kufr. طيب, this is the action of kufr. But لابد أن نفرق بين الفاعل والفعل. But if we must make the distinction between the person doing the action in the action itself. نعم بلا شك ولا ريب that using من تعلق تميمة فقد أشرك, that whoever يعني wear an amulet, that is an action of كفر of shirk تماما. But now can we, هل نعتبر لأن فاء صاحب هذا كافر, can we say that this individual is a kafir because he's wearing amulets? Now فيه تفصيل. We cannot just open, we see yes the action without no hesitation is the act of kufr. But now would we say to that individual, you are a kafir. Why? Because you wear amulets. لَعَلَّهُ لَا يَعْرِفْ. But perhaps the individual doesn't know. So the person that doesn't know his right is what? Yes, to teach him, to educate him. So he mentioned here, now. And of course, after yes.
If the individual believes that going to the soothsayer is a way of sorting good, and he really believes in his heart.
If he believes it, yes. That is a belief of kufr. But we still have to do certain things, meaning we have to yani, establish the proofs. And then, barakallahu fi, if the proofs are established, we do what is called raf'u al-mawani', yani remove the obstacles that are preventing him from accepting this. طيب? No, I mean, if now after that, he does that, then barakallahu fi, this individual is a kafir. But with that also, we're talking about general, but with that also to say this individual is a kafir, this is barakallahu fi, something that a scholar will do. You say, yeah, sure, this individual, this was the thing. We, alhamdulillah, clearly gave him the sign, the proofs and the evidence. And well, alhamdulillah, he was having yani, some shubuhat because of, you know, the imam of the masjid is the one that gave him this talisman and the like. Because most of the time, that's what happened. Or this individual that claim Islam that, you know what I'm saying, this guy, he say he's a hajjah, as we say. He's a person that went to Mecca a few times and he's the one that gave him this talisman, or he's a person that he memorized the Quran, he's the one that did him this for this and the like. Then you, I'm going to explain the situation. If he say that this individual, he's a kafir, then you can declare him to be a kafir. طيب. But amma to say you a kafir, this is not something barakallahu feekum. Alhamdulillah, none of us will do except that which is yani, crystal clear in the kufr. Crystal clear in the kufr. But if he persists and keep doing it, that the individual will abstain, will abstain from giving the salam, will abstain from barakallahu fikum eating his dhabiha and the like. But a man, now he's taking the ruling of a kafir. But a man to declare him as a kafir, this is something that he will have an alim to do that for him. Nah. Bismillah.
What if we said we did not know before we left the Muslim land the conditions?
Alhamdulillah, now we know.
Now we know. So now to stay, we have to fit in. I'm not a student. I'm not in the embassy. So I'm going to be a die.
Or you making, I mean, making yourself a die is not.